Hello guys, this is Fabio from Logic Pro 10 Tips on Cinematic Compositions, and today I would like to answer a question from Sebastian Morgan and the Eastwest Sounds online forum. He wanted to know, how is it possible to set the settings of Opus in Logic in order to have a multi-output? So to do that, I will show you with an example with drums coming from the library Ghostwriter. So how to do that? First, you have to open a MIDI track. So I will choose Opus, and it's very important to choose multi-output. So you have the choice between stereo and mono. So we're gonna choose stereo, and it's very important to select increasing here. So we're gonna open Opus and Ghostwriter. So now I will open a drum library. So the sound is there. Okay, so I had recorded this short MIDI phrase. Now we are going to the mixer of Opus. So as you can see here, the output of Opus is on output 1 and 2. And we have the others. The others output are on the master. So I will change the outputs. I will put output 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'm gonna play. So we have everything there, so that's good. Now we are going to open the mixer, and there, as you can see, there is this plus button, and you will hit it as much you can. And as you can see, we have all our parts, so that's great. And now I highlight my auxiliary tracks in my mixer by holding Alt and choosing the bus 2. I will have buses from 2 to 9, and then by going there, options, and create a track for each auxiliary, I will have my tracks there. Cool. So as you can see, we have all of parts there, the kick, the snare, the toms, everything is here now in the main window. And now I will create 7 audio tracks, and the inputs gonna be the buses from 2 to 9. So the audio tracks are there. Now I'm gonna hit record and play, and let the magic happen. So now we're gonna hit play to check. And as you can see here, the cymbals are of course taken by the overheads, and the overheads are also recording some other parts. This is normal, as it is normal on each drum kit. So we're gonna just check what we have in our overheads. So as you can see, the overheads are taking almost all the other parts. But so this is this method. Hope this video was useful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give me a like, share with your friends, let me a comment, and see you soon for another video. This is Fabio from Logic Pro 10 Tips and Cinematic Compositions. See you soon, guys. Have a nice day. Bye.